This week, I'll be showing you how to shoot the stars. Shooting the stars, or astrophotography, is a very specialist side to photography. As there's very little light about, your camera needs to be really good in low light, and you need a really fast lens, so basically one with a really big aperture. I took my first astrophotography picture with a Canon 350D, I think it was, and then the Sigma 1020. And now I shoot with a Sony A7R Mark II. I use two different lenses, the Samyang 14mm f2.8. It's surprisingly sharp for a sort of a lower end budget lens. Everything's manual on it, which is actually really good. You can set the focus in, you can set the aperture just by shining a light on the top of it. You don't even have to turn your camera on. The second lens I use is the Zeiss Batis 25mm f2. This is a really clear, concise lens. It takes beautiful photographs. It is on the pricier end, but the more you get into photography, the more you'll find you'll want to spend all of your money on gear. If you are shooting with a cropped sensor, I'd get something like a 10 to 20mm lens. You can get lots of stars in the shot, but you can also zoom in to 20 to get a slightly tighter shot, so it gives you a lot of scope and flexibility. So these are the steps. Get your camera on a good tripod. Turn the mode dial to manual. Turn on the self timer, preferably to 2 seconds. You don't want to be waiting around too long. Turn off any image stabilization, either in the lens or the body. Change your white balance setting to tungsten. This could be indoor or incandescent. If you're using a zoom, to start with, zoom out as wide as possible. Switch to manual focus. If you have markings on your lens to show you where to focus to, focus your lens to infinity. If you don't, this is the tricky part. Switch on live mode. Find a bright star or a light on the horizon and use the magnify button to zoom in on that light or star you found. Then use the manual focus ring to get a clean image. You may have to take a few images and then adjust the focusing slightly to get a good image. This is why lenses with a marker are better. You can see when the lens is at infinity. Then keep the focus in manual and try not to touch your focus ring. Set your ISO to about 10,000, have your aperture as wide as possible, and your shutter speed to about 6 seconds, and take a shot. Depending on the moonlight and any ambient light from cities nearby, your shot might be overexposed with these settings. If it is, just bring down your shutter speed. This first step is merely to find a pleasing composition. So you're saving time by having a high ISO and a low shutter speed. So ISO high, shutter speed low, take a photo, check the composition. If it's not good, move the camera, take the photo again, and repeat the process until you find a pleasing composition. Once you've got good composition and exposure, start bringing your ISO down and your shutter speed up. Just don't take your shutter speed up too much though, otherwise the stars will start to streak from the rotation of the Earth. Unless that's the look you're going for, however, then get them streaking as far as possible. There is a rule called the 600 rule, and it's basically you take your focal length and divide 600 by your focal length. This will give you the amount of seconds you can leave your shutter open before the stars start to streak. This is slightly different when it comes to APS-C. It's known as the 400 rule. So if you're shooting on an APS-C sensor, divide 400 by the focal length. That will give you a maximum shutter speed. So if you're on a kit lens at 18mm, you'll want a maximum shutter speed of about 22 seconds. I'd probably keep it to 20 seconds. If you're using a full frame camera, divide 600 by the focal length. Then it's just a case of coming up with interesting compositions and following the patterns of the moon and the stars to see what might give you an interesting sky. Sometimes if the ambient light is really bright, I'll have to drop the ISO, but not too much to lose the stars. So you're kind of battling with the light coming off the ground and the light coming in from the stars. If you do some research online, you'll see that people really get into this and it can get quite expensive. I tend to keep it to just a wide lens. I try and get the Milky Way or some moonlight, or just a nice, interesting sky full of stars. Normally, if you go out with a full moon, a lot of the stars will get bleached out by the brightness of the moon. I use an app called Photopills. It shows me where the Milky Way is going to be at any given time of the year. It shows me where the moon is and what cycle it's in, and also where the sun is. It's really good. It's just got so many different aspects to it. I use it all the time. I'm not sponsored by PhotoPills, but I love it. I use it all the time and it helps me so much. So that's about it. There are a lot of steps in this and it does take a while to get used to, but if you stick at it, you'll get some amazing shots. If you need to see the information written down or you want to print out these steps, go to my blog at boxheadmike.com. There, I'll have a list of these steps and how to go through them. I hope this has helped you and your astrophotography and motivated you to get out there and start shooting more. This is ultimately the only way you'll get better. As always, if you liked what you see, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give us a thumbs down. And if you want to see more, subscribe and turn on notifications. And if you've got any hints or tips about astrophotography or about shooting the stars differently, leave a comment below or send me an email. I'll see you in the next one.